This portion of the show is brought to you by Aztec Audio, Video, and Communications. Aztec has specialized in design and installation of both commercial and residential audio-video systems since 2001. Set up an appointment today to have one of their technicians help you set up and manage your in-house audio-visual needs. They provide free consultations to help you find what you're looking for. Be sure to check them out online at aztechav.com. That's aztechav.com.
Playing next to TJ Cudiay, that's kind of surreal.
You know, we've got a professional TJ Cudiay playing at the final table, so we'll have to definitely watch out for him.
Every time he raises, like, ugh.
You know, you always watch the guy on TV, and now you're sitting next to him, so that's kind of a cool experience.
Nice to be in the presence of that type of player, and just hope I hold on till the end.
They all seem to know how to play poker pretty good. That's good. I think they're all playing pretty decent.
Welcome back to Windy City Poker Championship. Our blinds are at 4 and 8,000 with a 500 chip ante. Todd is first to act.
Todd with 9-5 offsuit, he's going to throw that away.
Gino and TJ are going to fold, and now it's Alan's turn.
Make it 12.
He makes it 12,000, but the minimum raise is twice the big blind, so it's 16 all day.
These players just can't grasp that, can they, Kirk?
No, sir. Walter with 8-3 of diamonds, he's going to get out of the way. 7-4 of hearts for Ben, hoping for the flush maybe again. He's going to go all in, try his luck on this hand. Over to Brian in the big blind. He's got pocket eights. Now, he can't just call in this situation. This is an all-in or fold moment for Brian.
I'm all in too.
How much more is that? I don't know if I can get out, right?
Total. 12 more than you.
You're ahead, I call.
So with that call, we have three players in the hand. Two are all in for their tournament life. There's a main pot and a side pot. Right now, Brian's pocket eights are the best hand, but it's anybody's game right now.
Last time I was on TV, I left first, so I don't want to leave first, that's all.
The main pot has 23,000. That's the most Ben can win. The side pot is 43,000 between Alan and Brian. Here we go to the flop.
Six, ace, five.
Brian's pocket eights are still the best hand. Ben flops an open-ended straight draw. Alan is still looking for a queen or a 10.
And the turn brings a queen.
Again, the turn is no good to Brian. Queens take the lead right now.
And a nine, the queen takes it all.
Alan knocks out two players here at the final table. Michael, I'm going to catch up with those players, both Ben and Brian, to get their reaction to that last hand.
At least I wasn't seventh, I was sixth.
Nice games, good meeting you, man.
Nice playing with you guys.
Good luck, everyone.
So, Ben, you were pretty short stacked there at the end there. 4-7 hearts, you were pot committed, you're all in. Hoping for a miracle, didn't come.
I was just wishing for the best on that. I think I gave the guy who initially was low stack in the hand, I gave him all my chips. So the tides kind of turn really quickly in these games.
Now, this is your first time on a Windy City Poker Championship final table. What was it like to be under the lights and on TV?
It was pretty interesting, pretty exciting. Don't know, what can you do and not do. It kind of let the table seem kind of quiet. But next time I think I'll know a little bit more what to expect.
So Brian, we always love it when we see familiar faces. Unfortunately though, you have a similar outcome. You had pocket eights there and the guy ends up catching a queen on the turn. You know, what were you thinking about after you saw that you were still good after the flop?
Oh, I felt real good then. I mean, I had the best hand going in. The small blind was all in at the time, so I think the queen 10 was just trying to make a move, and he was pot committed, so he called my raise, and he caught a queen, so that's the way it goes.
We're down to five players here at Windy City Poker Championship, Michael.
Yeah, Kirk, a little more room at the table to play some cards.
There we go. Because of that last hand knocking two players out, we have a dead small blind, so there's only a big blind plus the antes in play right now.
All right, Gino's going to be first to act, and he has 10-9 off suit. He's going to fold. TJ with King Jack suited.
27.
He's going to raise and make it 27,000 all day, 2.5 times the big blind. It's just him and Todd right now. Todd's taking a look at TJ's chip stack. TJ's like, what? What? This is what I got.
All right, I'm all in.
All right, I can't throw it away for this.
Todd, what are you doing?
You're in the lead. By a long shot. I got two diamonds, that's all.
Kirk, I am getting sugar ready for you to put into that gas tank.
TJ still got some chances. Here we go. The flop. The flop is 7-8.
How do you like his hand now, boy?
Someone just hit me right
diamond,
in the stomach.
My only hope.
Todd fills up. Aces
nice
over sevens.
Y'all.
Oh my God.
TJ good. Is gone.
Look at Todd. It's the first time I've seen him smile because he just knocked out TJ Cloutier.
Did I tell mom you said hi?
Yeah.
Well, Kirk, you go talk to TJ about his experience here at Windy City Poker Championship.
All right, guys.
Now, this is definitely a pleasure for me. My dad's a big fan. He watches you all the time on the WPT Tour. TJ Cloutier at the Windy City Poker Championship. You make it to the final table, helping kids with cancer. What's it like for you playing in these charity tournaments?
Oh, I love it. Anything that's for a good cause, I like to be in. I'm in quite a few of them in over the years' time.
We'll be right back with more Windy City Poker Championship Final Table Play. But before we go, I had a chance to sit down and talk to professional poker player Rick Fuller at the WPT Boot Camp held recently here in Chicago. A lot of people out there, they want to become professional poker players. Coming to camps like this can help them get to that level. What's some advice that you would have for somebody who's looking to maybe play professionally or semi-pro?
Don't.
I shouldn't try to start, huh?
There's a lot of glamour, supposedly, in being a professional poker player, but it's a tough job. I mean, it's really, really difficult. There's so many highs and lows in this game. So if your goal is to become a professional poker player, you first have to know that you're going to experience highs and lows. You're going to experience swings, and you have to be prepared emotionally to handle them. The other thing is you really have to have a very self-sustaining bankroll. You can't even consider getting involved in being a professional poker player if you're living paycheck to paycheck right now, if you're playing above your bankroll. Most people who try it do not succeed. So if you're going to consider being a professional poker player, have a backup plan at least.
If you'd like to play in a future televised Windy City Poker Championship, here's a schedule of our future productions. But if TV isn't your thing, you should check out the non-televised tournaments being offered by Main Event Charity Games. So log on today and sign up at maineventcharitygames.com. Seats fill up very fast. For more information, you can email us. Our email address is info@windycitypokerchampionship.com.
Food and drink provided to players and crew by Cactus Bar and Grill. They're located in the financial district of downtown Chicago at 404 South Wells. With daily drink specials and signature drinks, Cactus is the perfect place to hang out and unwind. Be sure to try wings or tenders slathered with one of their world-famous Death Valley sauces, an experience like no other. For more information, log on to www.don'tdrinkandtrade.com.